Hi, I'm Nils Smith, and welcome to this vlog. In this episode, we're talking about Messenger bots and three keys to maximize Messenger bots for your Facebook page. Now, I went to Facebook's F8 conferences last year, and I felt like half of the conference was about Messenger bots. It was the buzz of the conference, and what they were talking about from a marketing perspective is that Messenger bots is opening up incredible new opportunities for marketers, and I couldn't even begin to wrap my mind around it. So I began to study Messenger bots to begin to understand what it is they do, how they work, and how someone can practically utilize them. Now, it sounds like Jetson stuff, like this is like so far out there and weird, but it's not as complicated as I think I perceived it to be at the beginning. And I think there's some immediate opportunities that we can begin utilizing these now. Even if we don't have, you know, big IT team and we're not real techie, we could begin utilizing Messenger bots today. And then I think we can begin to set ourselves up for the future, because this is a trend that isn't going to be here today and gone tomorrow. This is a trend that's going to continue. So we need to figure out how we utilize Messenger bots for our Facebook page. So here are three keys to understanding Messenger bots to help you begin to taking the first steps towards utilizing the platform. The first step towards building a Messenger bot is the build. So the build is essentially the choose your own path. So as you move into a Messenger bot, you can create a path for people to move down. So if they click here, you can have then a series of questions they answer. If they click yes or no, they go down this, yes, they go down this path, no, that they go down this path. And then you create paths as they choose their own path. Or you build a menu that is essentially moving your website into the Messenger bot, where people can then scroll through, you know, a series of sections that might be about us or learn more about our organization or watch our video series. And so you can essentially create paths for people to engage with. And so choosing that path or creating that build, creating the stream of pathways for people to go down is an important first step. Now, this might feel overwhelming at first, but as you jump into a platform like ChatFuel or ManyChat, they will give you tools to help you build your paths. And so set up a very simple introductory path. Basically, look at your website and how does that translate to these pathways? And so as you begin to build out these paths, it will begin to make sense. And that's your first step towards building your Messenger bot. Now, the second thing that you need to begin to understand with Messenger bots, and this is where I think it gets a little more complicated and where it gets really exciting in the future, is the artificial intelligence. This is where you can cue certain words to then have certain actions. So if somebody were to say interested, you might then have an automated message that can accuse, you know, interested. Or if they were to say, where's a store? And so if they're looking for a physical store location, you might then direct them to an answer that gives them a list of, here are store locations. As people begin to ask certain questions, you can cue, if they say this, then we respond with that. And so this system of artificial intelligence actually isn't too complicated at the beginning. Now, it can get more complex, but just what you'll begin to see is that people begin to say and ask and look for similar things. So just create some simple artificial intelligence that kind of creates a pathway for, if somebody says this, then lead them down this path and kind of create a new stream or a new path for them to go down, getting them the information they need instantly rather than having to wait for a person. Now, the third function, and I believe to be the most powerful function right now with Messenger bots, are the broadcast. Now, people can subscribe to your Messenger bots to begin to receive messages from your page. Now, this is a big deal, and I'll tell you why it's a big deal, because the open rates are over 90%. If you're in email marketing at all, you know that open rates above 20% are good. 90% is huge. And so we need to be paying attention to this opportunity within Messenger bots. So getting people to subscribe to our Messenger bot allows us to send messages to them at any time. Now, you can create lists and segments just like you can in MailChimp or other email systems where, you know, if they're subscribed to this pathway, they'll get these messages or this, that, or they'll subscribe to all of your messages. But you want to get people to subscribe to your bot in some way so that you can begin to directly message them the important information and news from your page. So get people to sign up and then begin to consistently send them broadcasts. But don't over-message people, don't spam them, don't overwhelm them, because they can unsubscribe just like they can in email. And it's actually even more secure than that the way Facebook monitors this. So make sure you move people towards subscribing to your broadcast and then engage them with consistent and valuable messaging through that medium. Now, there's a bonus tip that I want to share with Messenger bots as I'm getting to know them and beginning to utilize them for many of the organizations that I work with, and that's to not over-automate and to definitely personalize. To don't over-automate all of your communication with bots. People don't like talking to robots. What you can do is you can personalize your messaging within the bots, but then you can also have real people interacting and then interfacing. So with artificial intelligence, if your bot doesn't know the answer, it can say, I'm sorry, I'm just a robot. I don't know the answer to that, but I'm going to tag a person who's going to reach out to you as soon as they're available. And then you can have a real person reach out to them, communicate with them, or even midstream. You know, so if somebody's messaging the organization and they're going through a bot, a person can pop in and just say, hey, I'm Julie, you know, on behalf of the organization, and I just wanted to thank you for getting to know our bot. So these can be real-time interactions as well with real people. Doesn't all have to be bot-powered. The bot can augment your real, you know, person-to-person interactions and speed up the information that many people need to get instead of them having to wait on a person. Yet don't over automate everything to make it so difficult for somebody to talk to a person. So integrate real person-to-person interaction with the power of bot opportunities. So those are Messenger bots. As I'm getting to know them, they're continuing to mature and develop. I hope this vlog was helpful for you to get started with Messenger bots. I hope you'll utilize these for your Facebook page and really begin to maximize the power that exists today with Messenger bots as we prepare for the future and the excitement of what is coming as Messenger bots continue to become more and more a part of our social media strategy.